guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, hello, welcome, thank you so much for stopping by. Today's video is going to be my Boxycharm base and premium unboxing for the month of March. I'm not going to go too in-depth with everything about Boxycharm. I will have the link down below to the Boxycharm website as well as my referral link. If you guys do use that link, I do get like some extra points that I can use in like the Boxycharm shop. But if you want more information on just Boxycharm, each tier, and what you're supposed to be getting, I will have their website linked down below. Plus, I want to keep it a little bit shorter since this year I am going to be doing reviews of the month prior items and stuff, so I will have timestamps linked down below if you guys are just curious on what I got this month or the reviews on the previous month's items. But yeah, if you guys want to see what I got this month, then just keep on watching. So I have already looked inside my box and everything, so it is mostly just like skincare this month, so a little bit of spoilers, but I'm not going to be trying anything on my face. I'm just going to kind of talk about everything. I have used a couple of these items, so I kind of have an idea of some of them, but most of these I am just going to have to try out throughout the month and then let you guys know in next month's video. So the theme for this month is Boxycharm Lucky. First item was the choice item, and this is the Glow Recipe Banana Soufflé Moisture Cream. This is super, super hydrating. I don't like the taste of bananas. The smell I'm like on the fence about, but like I just need stuff to like hydrate my skin, like a very good hydrating moisturizer that's not too thick for like the daytime. But this is what the little packaging looks like, and it's just all in here. Once I get closer to the bottom, I might just have to like, it's pretty liquidy, so I think I could just like pour it out, because I was like, it's gonna get hard to get into like the bottom of that and get the product out. So I guess I'll just have to like keep dumping it out on the back of my hand. So this retails for $39, and it says a soothing lightweight moisturizer that seals in lasting hydration without clogging pores. It's non-comedogenic and non-acnogenic, making it especially good for sensitive skin. Blended with banana, chia seed, magnesium, turmeric, and cica, it's your recipe for hydrated, healthy looking skin. Alright, so next is this Illuminati Cosmetics sponge. And this retails for $21, and it says an endless reusable high definition cosmetic sponge applicator. Oh, that feels a little rough. I hope it does expand and get softer, because this is very like tough, and I feel like I would just like be beating my face and I'll give myself a black eye or something. Plus $21 for a sponge, like the Real Techniques one is good, the Eco Tools one, and then the Beaky Blender ones you get off Amazon are really, really good, and those are so much more affordable. So next is the KAB lip oil, and this is in the Juicy Melon shade. This one I really like already. I've used this a couple times. It is not this intense of a purple. It really is just a lip oil. Smells so good. You have a very large applicator, and I'm just going to apply this because it's a lip oil. So this is just super comfortable and super hydrating. I really do enjoy this. I think I'm gonna get a lot of use out of this because my lips get so dry so easily. This retails for $20, and it says, say goodbye to dry and thirsty and hello to juicy hydrated lips. Your lips will love this non-sticky instant burst of hydration that comes in 6 different tints. Slap this formula on for comfortable juicy lips all day long. And it doesn't really have that much of a tint to it. I don't know if it's just like my lip color underneath, but yeah. Super pretty, and I'm really glad it's not like some insanely like neon purple shade, because I could just wear this at work, keep my lips hydrated, and be good to go. So next is this 1-1 Skin Celestial Black Diamond Contour Gel. This one I am giving to my mom, so I'm not even going to be using this. This is the packaging of it here. It comes with like a little like applicator part. It's not like a squeezy tube and you just have to like massage it in. And this, like, it makes it cooling when you apply it, because I had something like this before. Or maybe my mom had something like it, and then I just used it because I was like, ooh, I want to feel it. But this I am going to be giving to her, so I will not be using this. So there will be no review on this next month. So this retails for $140. That is ridiculously expensive. But it says, the contour gel is a peptide packed treatment gel specifically developed to focus on deep set lines and wrinkles due to a loss of elasticity around the eyes and lips. And then the last item is the Frank Body Caffeinated Glow Mask. I love me some coffee, and I really hope this smells like coffee. So we will see. That was so impossible to remove. Doesn't smell like coffee. Anyways, this retails for $21.95, and it says, this moisturizing face mask is natural and ultra hydrating. It works to reduce puffiness and give skin extra life, glow, and brightness. It's perfect for pre-makeup, late nights, and morning afters. It's natural, cruelty-free, and only takes 5 minutes to work. All right, so this month's box retails for $241.95, and that's a really high retail value. But you gotta think this product right here is $140 itself. Overall, just kind of mediocre in the base box. I've definitely had better base boxes where I've enjoyed everything, even though the retail price was lower. All right, so now on to the premium box. Again, it's the same Boxycharm Lucky for the theme of the box. The next is this Kypros Illuminating Eye Serum and Primer and Shimmer Palette. This one I have already used as well. This is very nice for the under eyes. It made concealer like blend over it really, really nicely. It's not too thick, but it's not too like watery where you don't feel like it's doing anything. And then this is the shimmer palette, and this kind of came off, so that's a downside to it. Since this is a very expensive product, we will get to the price tag pretty soon, but it's all shimmers and they are really, really pretty. They're not your most insanely like blinding type shades, but we'll just swatch all of them for you here. But you can see they're all just really, really pretty. But yeah, this retails for $145 for these two items. And again, with that type of price tag, I really wish that the palette didn't come undone. This also says it's a new launch, and it says this pairing packs technology forward skincare first illumination and shimmer. The illuminating eye serum and primer creates the optical illusion of a brightened eye area, while the shimmer palette offers active, buildable shimmer for your eyelids and skin. This set is made exclusively for Boxycharm and is not for resale. Next was the choice item, and this is the Hangover RX from Too Faced, and it is the Replenishing Face Primer. I did pick this one because I was definitely excited to have this again because I did enjoy it a lot. I'm not going to use it right now because I obviously have a full face of makeup on already. I know how I feel about this, and I have other primers that are currently open, so I will put this on hold, but I will be using this sooner or later. This retails for $35, and it says this revolutionary makeup primer is infused with coconut water, probiotic-based ingredients, and skin revivers that work together to boost skin's radiance, promote elasticity, and help you hydrate while locking down makeup for fresher, longer, more flawless wear. Then we have this IGK Prenup Instant Spray Hair Mask. It retails for $32, and it says this high-powered in-shower treatment performs like a traditional hair mask but works in under a minute. A multitasking mix of moisturizers including almond oil and kapuaku butter deep condition, repair, and strengthen hair, while apple cider vinegar adds dramatic shine. I'll have to keep it on for a minute. Oh, that's nice. Definitely excited to give this a go. Then we have this Kiss My from Rowan. And this is a liquid lip balm. It retails for $26. Ooh, that's a pretty shade. Okay, this is what it looks like here. This is what it looks like. I'm just gonna put it on top, keep my lips, you know, even more hydrated, I guess. It's kind of like my lips, but better. This is a really nice lip combo. I don't know what's like more hydrating. I probably need to try this one on its own and see, but together with the other lip product, this feels a little bit cooling on the lips. It doesn't have like a weird stick to it where it's gonna like show like gloopiness. So it really is more of like a lip balm in a liquid lipstick packaging, lip gloss packaging, versus like a sticky lip gloss. Again, it retails for $26, and it says a non-sticky alternative to classic lip gloss. This liquid lip balm soothes the lips as it nourishes, regenerates, and repairs. Formulated with mango and grapeseed oils to hydrate and protect, it gives the high shine of a gloss with the nourishment of a balm. So next is this Dose of Colors single eyeshadow in the shade Reflection. I don't reach for single shadows much, I'm not gonna lie. I've gotten better with the ColourPop Super Shock shadows, reaching for those. It is what I have on my lids, my inner corner today, but this is what the single shadow looks like. It does have a little mirror here, so I'm covering that up, but ooh, that is so pretty. I don't even know how to describe that color. Oh, this one will probably be an excuse for me to reach for single shadows. Can't wait to use this. So this eyeshadow retails for $20, and it says this eyeshadow is packed with multi-dimensional reflex, creating an ultra dazzling finish. Each eyeshadow comes in its own mirrored compact. So last is this eyeshadow brush set from Beauty Diva London. So these are the four brushes. You have an angled brush, a crease type brush, a even fluffier crease type brush, and then like a flat shading brush. This is what the four brushes look like. They feel pretty soft. Can't wait to use these for eyeshadows and see how they actually perform. And these four retail for $48, so it is pretty pricey. That's $12 a brush. Very pricey, but it says, perfect your eye looks with this cruelty-free brush set for eyeshadow and eyeliner. So I'll definitely have to give these a go. Again, I love getting brushes because I can use them for my normal makeup and for my body paints. For my premium box, the retail value is $306. I just wish that the palette in here was better quality because, again, for $145, I don't want the cardboard to like unglue from the backing cardboard thing. Like, I want it to stay together. But yeah, overall, I'm very excited with this premium box. All right, so now on to the reviews of the items from last month's box. I'm not gonna go in like the premium base box order. I'm just gonna grab and talk about each item. This first one is the NCLA So Rich Cuticle Oil. It's very nice, it's hydrating, but again, it's just a cuticle oil. It's something I can use, but I'm not over the moon excited about it. I have other cuticle items like cuticle balms and stuff that are cheaper, and I like those just as much. So I will get use out of this one, but nothing to write home about. This right here is the Bali Balm Sweet Orange and Coconut Lip Balm. Such a nice lip balm. I have been using this so much, and it barely looks like I've made a dent in it. A little bit goes such a long way with this. Then we have the Laura Mercier Highlight 01 Matte Radiance Powder. And it is a bit powdery. You can see the mirror here has some kick up, but I did use this today as an all-over face setting powder very lightly, and it just made the foundation not look as matte, but it's also not built up as an intense highlight like I've been wearing before. Definitely excited to be using this more. I just don't know if I should start with my highlights now or with my face powders. Then we have the Rhodial Soft Focus Glow Drops. There is the scent to this that I'm just not the biggest fan of, but it works really nicely. Foundation and everything over top of this looks flawless, so I really am happy with this product. I just kind of hold my breath and then just not smell it when applying it because I just don't like the smell of this. Then we have the Ace Beauté Nostalgia Palette, and such a pretty vibrant pigmented formula, and I really enjoyed everything I did with it. I love that there's more mattes than shimmers, and the formula is impeccable, so I'm very, very happy with this palette. Next, we have the Tarte Double-Ended Eyeliner. Very nice eyeliner. The liquid pen is very precise, very pigmented, very long-lasting. The pencil side applies very nicely, and you have time to smudge it out, but once it is set, it is set, and it's not going anywhere until I remove it with my makeup remover at the end of the day. I just find it really convenient because it's a liquid and a pencil in one, and when I do like a winged liner and I want to bring it down on my lower lash line a little bit, it gets very difficult to do with a liquid, so I always have to go grab a pencil. But now I just do my wing and then do a little bit on the lower lash line with the pencil side, and I'm done, and it's great. I really enjoy this. So next are the Glamier brushes. These are pretty good. They're not the best brushes, but they're not horrible. I love how small and flat this one is. It is perfect to apply a dark shadow on the lower lash line as like a bottom line liner. This one is a really nice smaller like fluffy brush because you can see I definitely have small eyes. So it's really easy to just blend in and do some crease work with it. This one I definitely find better to pack on like some matte shadows. For this type of brush, initially I thought like, oh, I'll grab it with like a shimmer and then apply the shimmer to the lid. It's not my favorite for shimmers, but if I want to pack on a matte base on my eyes, this is a really nice brush for that. This one right here is very nice just to get a wing shape for me. So they are good brushes. They're not my absolute favorite, but they're not bad. Next is this Wander Beauty Double Date Lip and Cheek. I love this peachy shade. I have been using this so much as a cream blush on just like natural makeup days. I do my moisturizer and then I'll use a cream bronzer, this blush, and then I just set my face with translucent powder and then apply a highlight and I'm good to go. It's not my favorite lip shade, but I've used it a ton as a cream blush. The clear balm here I've been using as a lip balm, but it's okay. It's not as nice as this or just other lip balms in general. And I don't really like the feeling of this as like a highlight, just to have like a glossy like cheek. I prefer, you know, actual like highlighters that have like the shimmer particles in them. So this bottom part isn't my favorite, but the top part, I think, is my favorite cream blush shade. So this is the Otisite Blue Aura Turmeric and Holy Basil Cleansing Water. It's a very nice cleansing water. I've mainly been keeping it just at my desk to remove like smudging for like eyeliner, clean up the lines a little bit, any eyeshadow fallout, but I have not used this to remove like full-on makeup. I usually just been putting this on my makeup eraser, and when I do like swatches just to see like what color I want to use, I just remove it quickly with that so I don't have to go get water to run my makeup eraser under and just do it that way. So I've really been enjoying this. I will have to still try it out as like an eye makeup remover thing. Then we have the Huda Beauty Pastel Lilac Palette. It is so, so pretty. These shimmers are so dimensional. Like, look at the shifts in these shimmers. They are so, so pretty. So yeah, the shimmers really make this palette for me, but the mattes are very soft, blendable, easy to work with. Especially with spring coming up, I feel like I'm going to reach for this a lot for a quick springy pastel look. We all know I love my grungy greens, but like, this is nice for the springtime without going like too dark with a purple, especially for work. So I really, really like this palette. And then the one item I have not used yet, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to enjoy, is going to be the Tula Deep Exfoliating Blackhead Scrub. I have a couple other face washes and everything open right now, so I just didn't want to open this yet. I enjoy everything I've tried from Tula so far, so I'm pretty sure I'm going to enjoy this as well. This is what it looks like, and ooh, okay. So it's not the roughest exfoliator at all, at least how it feels on my hand. You've got that little bit of a gel texture to it. It's not just like gritty particles. I'm definitely going to be using this soon. All right guys, so that was it for my March BoxyCharm base and premium unboxing, as well as reviews of the items from my February box. Let me know what you guys got in your boxes this month, what you thought about some of the items I tried last month. But for March, even though I had good items, it just didn't compare. Let me know what you guys thought about the items I got in this month's box. Let me know what you guys got, what you thought about your box. And yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button down below and turn on the little bell notifications so you guys know every single time that I upload. And yeah, I love you guys and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.